Hello, students. It's Professor Del Russo, and we are moving along in Chapter 4, The Ground Rules. The next ground rule I want to discuss is the tell me you don't understand ground rule. Now, Professor Poole points out that there is not a lot of science to back up how to exactly do this. And the efficacy, that means the effectiveness of offering a ground rule about not understanding or a lack of comprehension, is still not demonstrable. So it's still important to offer that. And can it hurt? Well, I guess it can take away from the interview, certainly the efficiency of it. It can be time consuming if you're doing it in a way that is inefficient and doesn't really pay dividends. Nevertheless, like all the ground rules, we recommend that you offer the ground rule and then that you practice it. And this one about telling me that you don't understand is especially important because, as we've discussed time and again, kids think that the interviewer knows everything. They might be reluctant to challenge us. They may think they understand. There's a lot of reasons why we need to make sure that we're vigilant about this issue. So what we recommend in Child First Finding Words, and it's similar to what Professor Poole speaks of in Chapter 4, you make a statement that's nonsensical or one that is sensical, but the child is not expected to understand it. The one that we use is something like this. Daniela, what is my ocular density? Or Daniela, what is my ocular reading or rating? Something like that. And that has to do with the eyes or the eye color. I forget exactly what the question is, but it refers to eye color. And it's unlikely that the child would understand that. And if the child says, I don't know what that means or I don't understand, then you praise them and say, that's right. Thank you for telling me that you don't understand. And if I say something that you don't understand later on when we talk, you tell me, Joe, I don't understand. Now, sometimes they may give you a response and it's unlikely that they know the answer. So the response is likely something that they made up or something that they, you know, extrapolated from the room that they're in or whatever. If they give you a response that's nonsensical or non-responsive, then just like in the last ground rule when we talked, you want to try to clarify and maybe ask the question again a different way or tell them, do you really understand what ocular density is? Let me try again. What is the square root of pi? You know, something like that. And I don't understand. And you need to clarify that. And if you get a response where they say, I don't understand, you reinforce it, you praise them, and then you move on.